Hello everybody. So in today's lesson, I want us to go through how we can configure a wireless access point. And a wireless access point from the perspective where one can be able to connect to the router wirelessly, or any wireless device is able to connect to the SSID of the router and get internet connection. So this is a diagram that I've just pulled from somewhere from the web. And I have two of these. I have two hoplites with me here. And what I want us to do is I want us to configure the Wi-Fi access point for this. Then I want the second, our second hoplite to be able to connect to the first one wirelessly. So we are going to do that. And then probably in the next video, I'm going to do a video on how to configure CAPSMAN. So be sure to watch out for that. So let's get straight into it and log into our first router. So here is our first router. As you can see, I've given it the name Mr. Wisp AP. So it's going to act also as an access point. So at this point, I'm also assuming that the router that you have is configured and you're able to traverse the internet using it. Let's just see if we have internet connection here. Yes, we do. So let's go and configure the wireless part of it. So you come to wireless or wireless Wi-Fi interface, and usually you'll find that this is not enabled. So you just click on the checkbox right there to enable it. So let's get right into it. The general mode, you have some few things including the MAC address. Then you come to the wireless tab. Our mode here, this is now going to be our AP bridge. It's going to act as an access point. And our band, I would prefer that you go with the BGN. The channel width remains at 20 megahertz. And then the SSID, this you can put whatever name that you want. So for mine, I'm going to call this Mr. Wisp. Let's see any other information that we need to change. Yeah, for the frequency mode, I would recommend that you leave it as regulatory domain. And country, let's change this to Kenya because that's where I am. And the type of installation that you're doing, are you planning to use it indoors or outdoor? So I'm just going to pick indoor for this. And basically that's all that you need. I'm going to click apply and okay for that. So secondly, I'm going to put a password for it. So you come to the security profiles, come to the default profile and do some editing on that. So the mode here is going to be dynamic keys, and I'm going to choose WPA2, and let's input a password. For purposes of demonstration, I'm just going to use a simple password: 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Apply that. Okay, so guys, basically that's all that you need to configure the wireless part for your router. And after that, this router is now, the SSID is going to be visible to any wireless device, and anybody can connect to it. And when they input the password that we've just entered, they should be able to have internet connection. So that is the first part that we wanted to configure. So let's jump into the second router. Let me just connect it. So I'm going to open a new second Winbox. It's also one that has been reset. It has no configuration. So we are going to do the configuration from scratch. So no password, connect. There you are. So this is the second MikroTik that we now need to work on. So let me just first input the identity, system identity, and let me just call this Mr. Wisp station. I'm calling it station because it's now going to act as a station, but you can give it any other name that you want, really. So the next thing that we now need to do for this second router to be able to get connected to the first, and that connection is actually going to happen wirelessly. So we come to the wireless tab and then click on the WLAN, then you're going to enable that. The next thing I want us to come to security, then do a bit of editing here. The mode is going to be dynamic. We are going to pick that. And the pre-shared key that we are now going to use for the second router, this is going to be the pre-shared key that we used in the first router. If you use a different one, they are not going to communicate, or rather the second router is not going to get connected to the first one. So the password that I used was 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Then I'm going to click OK. Then let's get back to the Wi-Fi interface. Let's open this up and then let's come to the wireless tab. So this is going to be a station, and the band for this is also going to be BGN. So what we now need to do is we need to look for the SSID of the first MikroTik router, and MikroTik has a cool feature here, scan. So we can be able to scan and see the routers that we have near us. So the interface here is going to be WLAN 1, then start. So this is the router that we want to get connected to. This one here, you can see the SSID is Mr. Wisp. That's the one that we want. So you click on that, then connect. Then after that, maybe we would also want to change the country to Kenya, the installation to Indo, and then apply. Okay. So in a few seconds, you should be able to see R here. That means it's running, and that means they are already connected. So when you come to the registration, you should also be able to see that connection here. So after that, let us try and ping and see if the router has internet connection. So you can see we have no internet connection here. So I'm just going to leave it running as it is. Let's just minimize it somewhere down here. Then now what we now need to do for this second router now to have access to internet is you need to come to IP and then Dhcp client, and then we are going to add a Dhcp client on the WLAN 1. Apply that. Okay, we've been assigned an IP, and you can now see our ping status has changed and we are now able to traverse the internet. So let's close that as well. So maybe another setting that you might want to do is you might also want the second router to be able to give out internet through its ports. So we are just going to create a bridge right here. Call it bridge 1. Okay, then let's just add some few ports quickly. Ether 1. Okay, we are going to add Ether 2. That's typical of MikroTik because I'm connected to Ether 1. Let's reconnect back. Let's add our second interface. Okay. Let's add our third interface. Okay. Let's add the fourth interface as well. Okay. Then we are going to close that. We are going to give that bridge an IP address. So let's give it 172.20.20.1/24, and this one goes to our bridge. Okay. So the next thing that we want to do is maybe we want to NAT that address. So we come to firewall, NAT, add. Our source address is 172.20.20.0/24, and the action here should be masquerade. Apply. Okay. The next thing that we want to do is we want to set up a DHCP server for the same. So let's just set it up quickly. This one goes to the bridge. Next, next, that looks okay. Next, that also looks okay. Next, next, and that is successful. So anybody who plugs in a cable either on port 1, 2, 3, or 4 is now able to get internet through the second router that we have just configured. Another thing that you can do for the second router is that you can also configure its own wireless part. So you come to the wireless Wi-Fi interface, and now for this case what we want to do is we want to add another virtual interface here. Let's reconnect back. Wi-Fi interface, then you want to add another virtual interface. So the name is going to be WLAN 2, and then the wireless tab mode, this is now going to be access point bridge. And then for this you can also give it its own SSID. So maybe we can say Mr. Wisp 2. Let's just give it that. And then the master interface, this now is WLAN 1. So let's see what else we need to change. It's just that. So you apply that and then click on OK. So for the security of the second Wi-Fi interface that we've just added, because it also, you also need to configure a password for that, you just come to security, then add another security profile. Let's say this is going to be profile 1. The mode is going to be dynamic key. We are going to pick that, and let's say the password for this may be 98765 4321. We are going to apply that, and you are going to click OK. So we've added the security for our Wi-Fi. So let's go back to the interface list and pick that security profile that we've just added. So you can see we have security profile here. So just come and click on the drop-down menu, and then pick profile 1. You remember profile 1 is the name of the security profile that we created. So you click apply and click OK. So that's all that you need to do. And maybe if we just come to our wireless interfaces, you should be able to see all. You can see we have Mr. Wisp and we have Mr. Wisp 2. So ladies and gentlemen, that's how you are able to configure a wireless access point. and you can also able to configure a second router to connect to your first router wirelessly. That's how you do it. And